My name is Chris Cooper, and this is the state of the fitness industry. Now let's talk about online advertising, how gyms get clients. Super interesting data because 5 years ago, almost nobody was doing Facebook ads. Everybody was advertising, but advertising had a bad name, and even marketing, which isn't the same thing, had a bad name. So let's talk about what percentage of owners have run ads in the past, are currently running ads like on Facebook, and what the change is. And then we'll talk about profitability. So 91% of yoga studios have run some kind of online ad in the past. Only 82% are currently running ads. Very interesting. So most of them have tried it. Not all of them are doing it anymore. In CrossFit gym, 80% of CrossFit gyms have run ads online. Only 43% are currently running ads. That's scary. And what that tells you is that the ads aren't working for them. And we can get into why that is later on or in our other podcast. Martial arts, 100% have run ads. Only 50% are currently running ads. Now look, we all know that ads work, right? I mean, most gym owners have signed up for Facebook ad marketing or mentorship or consulting or lessons or swipe files because they were guided there by a Facebook ad, right? It works on us. It works on our clients. What this really tells me is that the ads didn't work for the gym owner. So it's very much like saying, I've got 10 relatives. They all started CrossFit and 50% stopped because it didn't work. Well, that doesn't mean that CrossFit doesn't work. It means that the program didn't work for them or the coach didn't work for them or something like that, okay? And then, of course, these numbers are scattered across the board. But what's really interesting is that 61% of businesses that do not currently run ads are profitable. 66% of businesses that do currently run ads are profitable. Now, all these gyms are doing marketing, but some gyms are doing it without advertising. There's a huge difference. When we dug deeper and we said, why aren't you running ads anymore, to the people who had stopped, they said that they got 30% said it was because of poor ROI or the lead quality that they got were really bad. And so that tells me that they were just running the wrong ads to the wrong people for the wrong duration, basically. 21% said that they don't need to. They have success with other methods. This is my gym. We do amazingly well with referrals and affinity marketing. We just don't need to run a Facebook ad. 12% said that they saw a big decline due to COVID. Their ad costs went up and they just weren't getting the traffic. So they're selling the wrong thing or they're doing it at the wrong time. 10% said they just gave up, lack of know-how. They didn't know what they were doing. 6% said they were full. They didn't have any room for new members, which is absolutely fantastic. 6% said that they couldn't afford to pay for the ads. And the rest, basically just said they had other reasons or they weren't sure why they stopped. A lot of people have worked with marketing agencies. So 38% of the gyms, well over a third of all gyms in the survey, have worked with a marketing agency, but only 14% currently work with a marketing agency. That means 63% of those who have signed up with a marketing agency have quit, and 59% say that they had a bad experience. So 56% said they quit using their marketing agency because they had bad ROI, or they didn't meet expectations, or they didn't deliver on their promises. 17% said the agency wasn't skilled. And that tells me like the gym owner actually knew more than the marketing agency did. 10% said unethical practices. That's scary to me because that's like negative marketing, right? 7% said they were getting bad leads. 5% said lack of support. Okay. And other reasons were deals falling through, trial periods that they didn't continue with the marketing agency, that kind of thing. All right. Let's talk about leads and signups. What does it cost you to get a new client from your marketing? In a yoga studio, it costs you about $29 to get a client, to get a new lead, right? So that's not a new signup. That's just to get a person interested enough to click through to your website, basically. In martial arts, it costs about $82 to get a new lead. Now, martial arts gyms in this survey at least spent more on marketing because their fixed costs and their expenses are so low that the more people they can get into their classes, the better. They also have great retention, so it's worth having a high cost to acquire a client. Personal training, $23 to acquire a lead. CrossFit, $35 to acquire a lead. All right. The average leads and signups. So here's where things really start to compound. Average leads per month. Gyms that had like a varied, you know, offering, mostly selling access, but they might have a yoga class, a bodybuilding class, you know, a kickboxing class. They were getting about 30 leads a month. The average CrossFit gym gets about 15. Yoga gets slightly less with about 12. Martial arts gets about 5. Okay. And again, not all these leads will come from marketing.